Dear veterinarian, welcome to YouTube channel, and our channel is Dr. Vet, DRVET. I am Dr. P.R. Patel. Today's topic is parturient paresis, popularly known as milk fever. We have divided this video in two parts, part 1 and part 2. In part 1, we will see definition, calcium homeostasis, incidence of milk fever, and signs of milk fever. Some of the signs of milk fever are also covered in part 2. Diagnosis, treatment, and prevention. First, we will see here what is milk fever or parturient paresis. It is a disease of adult female of bovine. It also occurs in other animals also, sheep and goat also. Generally occurring around parturition and caused by hypocalcemia, decreased calcium level in blood. Disease is generally characterized by great weakness, recumbency, animal is unable to get up, or difficulty in standing up. There is paresis of the hind legs. And if the disease is very serious, there is shock and death of the animal. Here we will see calcium homeostasis, how the calcium level in extracellular fluid is maintained. When there is decrease in level of calcium in extracellular fluid, it stimulates parathyroid gland to produce more hormone, parathyroid hormone. This hormone affect the bone and it causes calcium resorption from the bone and there is increased calcium level of extracellular fluid. The another way, the hormone effect on kidney, there is calcium resorption, more phosphate excretion that lead to increased calcium level of extracellular fluid. From the small intestine, also there is increased calcium absorption that also cause a rise in calcium level of extracellular fluid. So here we have seen a very preliminary about calcium homeostasis. Here we will see incidence of milk fever. Generally, milk fever occur in adult 5 to 10 years of age group. Is commonly affected and more prevalence is observed during 3rd to 7th calving. because during third to seventh calving there is more milk production. One precipitating factor is that complete milking in first 48 hours after parturition may increase the chance of incidence of milk fever. Milk fever cases may also occur during the last few days of pregnancy, but number of cases are comparatively less and generally occur immediately after parturition. Remember here, majority of cases occur within 72 hours after parturition. This is the important thing. For diagnosis, this is important. Most of the cases occur within 72 hours after parturition. The acid diet decreases the incidence because the acid diet makes the soluble calcium product and calcium will be absorbed, while alkaline diet increases the incidence. Generally, with the high protein diet before and after calving, the alkaline diet makes insoluble calcium product. So, absorption of the calcium is difficult. So, alkaline diet increases the incidence of the milk fever. Now we will see the clinical findings of milk fever. Generally, the disease is described in three stages. These stages are not clear-cut demarcated, but the stages are arbitrary. The stages overlap with each other. The clinical signs varies with the stage of disease. There are three stages. Stage 1 is called as prodromal stage. Stage 2, sternal recumbency, where the animal is unable to get up. Animal sits down on sternum. And the third stage, lateral recumbency. The calcium level of the serum decreases to a great extent that even the animal is unable to even sit on the sternum. So there is lateral recumbency. The signs of stage 1. In initial stage, there is excitement. Animal looks excited. There is tetany of the muscles. There is tremor also. The animal is hypersensitive. Even hypersensitive to some normal stimuli. When normal stimuli is applied to the animal, animal shows little bit exaggerated response. There is tremor of muscle, especially of head and limb. There is anorexia and movement of the animal is affected. grinding of the teeth. The tongue is protrude out from the mouth. There is stiffness of hind limbs. The limbs become very stiff. Animal shows ataxia, incoordination of movement. There is difficulty in walking, and animal falls very easily. Thank you very much for observing the Dr. Ved channel. Requested to subscribe the video so that you can get more and more video notification. Share those who want to get the knowledge. Thank you very much for observing this video.